Yesterday morning at 2:41 a.m. at General Eisenhower's headquarters, General Jodl, the representative of the German High Command, and of Grand Admiral Dönitz, the designated head of the German state, signed the act of unconditional surrender of all German land, sea, and air forces in Europe to the Allied Expeditionary Forces and simultaneously to the Soviet High Command. Today is Victory in Europe Day. Tomorrow will also be Victory in Europe Day. But let us not forget for a moment the toils and efforts that lie ahead. Japan, with all her treachery and greed, remains unsubdued. The injuries she has inflicted upon Great Britain, the United States and other countries, and her detestable cruelties call for justice and retribution. We must now devote all our strength and resources to the completion of our tasks, both at home and abroad. Advance, Britannia! Long live the cause of freedom! God save the King!
On many a brilliant occasion in the past, the people of these great-hearted, unconquerable islands have swarmed outside the palace, but never was there a deeper, more heartfelt expression of joy than this. We had won through. Britain and the great family of Britain throughout the world rejoiced as never before. Winston Churchill, surely the finest leader our country ever produced, drove to Parliament, the mother of parliaments, birthplace and center of modern democracy, to make there also the formal announcement that the long war was over. In and about Whitehall, fully 50,000 people, like millions all over the country, gave themselves over to unbounded rejoicing. If anybody still believed that we didn't know how to enjoy ourselves, these victory days disprove them once and for all. Winston Churchill came onto the balcony of the Ministry of Health. Ernest Bevin was there, a burly man who had done a big job, John Anderson, Oliver Littleton, Walton, Morrison, all the cabinet colleagues who'd helped the PM. But it was Winston the crowd wanted.
Neither the long years nor the dangerous. the fierce attacks of the enemy have in any way weakened the unbending resolve of the British nation.
All those people who said there'd be no jollifications, how wrong they were. The millions of ordinary men and women who'd been working away long hours, year after year, they just couldn't contain what they felt. They had to go out and make a noise. It was victory. Every modern comfort. When night fell, there were still the great crowds, bigger than ever. All London made a night of it. Piccadilly Circus was the center of it all. Those who stayed at home had parties of their own.
The shepherd will tend his sheep. The valley will bloom again. Tomorrow.